Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about Tesla's claim that they're going to be hitting 60 miles per hour in 1.9 seconds in the new Tesla Roadster. Now many of you pointed out in the comments on my channel that I claimed that no production car will exceed 60 miles per hour in less than 2.05 seconds for a production car. There were disclaimers that went along with that, which many of you chose to ignore. No big deal, we'll get into that later. Point is, Tesla says they can do this in 1.9 seconds, 60 miles per hour. Now Elon has a tweet saying 62 miles per hour, basically he says 100 kilometers per hour. We're gonna ignore that and just go with their official documents, which all say 60 miles per hour in 1.9 seconds, 100 miles per hour in 4.2, and a quarter mile in 8.8 seconds. Now, the first thing we have to talk about is that these are all claims. There is no production Tesla Roadster out there that's actually doing this that's been verified by a third party. Just like the, Devil 16 is going to hit 300 miles per hour, the Hennessy Venom F5 is going to hit 300 miles per hour. None of these things have actually happened in production cars. So until they actually happen, truthfully, it's all meaningless. Like, it doesn't really matter. You don't know what's going on behind the scenes with prototypes as far as how they function. But they claim it's going to happen. I think there's reason to believe why it will happen. And so we're going to get into that. So let's go along and just assume the fact that in the year 2020, according to Elon's production schedule, which, as we know, doesn't always work out, but according to him, by the year 2020, we're going to have these Tesla Roadsters are going to be hitting 0 to 60 in 1.9 seconds. Now, the first thing we need to address, and something that I've been disappointed that not a single outlet, as far as I can tell at this point, has actually spoken about rollout when it comes to the 0 to 60 time for this car. I actually tweeted at them, I sent them emails, I've been asking to find out if they include or exclude rollout in their 0 to 60 times. As of recording this video, they have not gotten back to me, but I will of course share that information if they do in the comments below. But basically, whether or not they're including rollout is whether or not this is super impressive or not. If, for example, this is a true 0 to 60 time, starting from exactly zero, and they're hitting 60 in 1.9 seconds, they're beating that claim that I made earlier. Super exciting. It is actually really cool what they're doing. If they're including a foot of rollout in that time, so they're basically what they're doing is that first foot of movement of that car is not recorded. And then after that foot, they start recording. So you're actually, maybe 5-6 miles an hour or so already before you get started into that 0 to 60 time, because you've got a foot that isn't measured. This is how all the major outlets do it. Motor Trend, Car and Driver, Road and Track. They exclude that first foot of time. And that makes the 0 to 60 times look better by about 0.2 to 0.3 seconds. It's just the convention that everyone uses that has its heritage back in drag racing. So basically, if they are not, if this 1 foot is excluded in the time, the actual 0 to 60 is 2.1, 2.2 seconds. And what I said previously holds true. No one has will be beating that 2.05, assuming tire technology doesn't improve. Now, on Tesla's website, they claim the 0 to 60 for the P100D is 2.5 seconds, which leads me to believe that they're actually doing the true 0 to 60 here of 1.9 seconds, rather than, excluding that first foot of rollout. However, Elon has tweeted in the past talking about the P100D and saying 0 to 60 in 2.3 seconds, Motor Trend spec ignoring that first foot of rollout. And so, we truly don't know which to believe until they release a statement and say what they mean as far as this 0 to 60. Time for the remainder of this video. We'll just kind of assume that they're going to do that 0 to 60 truly starting from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 1.9 seconds. Okay, now let's take a moment and appreciate just how brutal the acceleration in this car would be if it could accelerate from 0 to 60 in 1.9 seconds. Average acceleration is equal to the change in velocity over the change in time, blah, blah, blah. We do some math. We find out that it's capable of accelerating at 1.44 average Gs across that 0 to 60 time. Extremely impressive. And basically, the next best thing we have to compare to is the Dodge Demon. Now, the Dodge Demon hits 60 in 2.3 seconds. That's none of this rollout nonsense. Basically, just straight up from 0 miles per hour to 60 miles per hour in 2.3 seconds. It hits 30 miles per hour in just a second. So we know that based on that, it would have the grip to do it 0 to 60 in 2 seconds flat, which is already faster than that 2.05 claim that I made. As I mentioned in this video, if tire technology improves, that time can go down. Well, tire technology improved shortly after with the Nitto drag radials that go on the Dodge Demon. Yes, it's on a prepared drag surface. It's using 100 octane fuel, but they are street legal drag radials. And as a result, people seem to accept the fact that this can hit 60 in 2.3 seconds. Again, I don't think it's been third party verified with an instrumented test, but we all seem to agree that it can happen. Okay, so based on tire grip alone, knowing that the Demon could hit 60 in 2 seconds flat if it didn't have to worry about things like changing gears, power, that kind of thing, we know that it has the grip to do it. Is there anything we can learn from that that could make us say, okay, yeah, it is logical that a Tesla Roadster could hit 60 in 1.9 seconds? And I think there are some things to point out. First of all, the Dodge Demon lifts the front end and then it comes back down. Now, when it comes back down, what that tells us is that there's weight on that front axle. You can actually steer the car a bit, you know, correct, and that means there's a load on the front axle. But that load on the front axle isn't doing anything to accelerate the car. So if the car were all-wheel drive, like the Tesla Roadster, it could actually use those front tires to help accelerate more quickly. And so that would be the case, 1.9, not a whole lot quicker than 2.0. And as if that front end were to come down and you would still have weight on it, especially in the case with this Tesla Roadster, which is going to have a big heavy battery pack that's very low, keeping the center of gravity low, you're not going to have all that weight transfer to the rear like you do with the Dodge Demon. A 1.9 second is very reasonable. Additionally, Dodge claims that the Dodge Demon hits 1.8 G's peak G-force right at the start. Now, if you're to assume that the tires are able to maintain 1.8 G's of acceleration, then you can hit a 0 to 60 time in just 1.52 seconds. Top fuel cars are doing it in 0.8 seconds. So ultimately, all this comes down to is tire technology. As tire technology improves, we will see 0 to 60 times go down. As it remains the same, we won't see much improvement in 0 to 60 times, no matter how much power you throw at these vehicles. Okay, now let's go back to my claim that I think that there won't be a production car hitting 0 to 60 in less than 2.05 seconds. Now, that was based on a braking of actually a Corvette, which had the shortest stopping distance, and using the deceleration of that and assuming that was the maximum amount of grip that those tires had. Now, the flaw with this is that you assume ABS is reacting as perfectly as possible, when in reality, electric traction control, when you have an electric motor that's finding grip, if it starts to see slip, it adjusts the power sent to that wheel, can happen much more quickly than an ABS motor, which is using a pump and a fluid to pump those brakes back and forth very quickly to produce that braking force. When it sees the tire lock up, it releases. When it sees that it's gripping again, it holds back down. So an electric motor can adjust much more quickly as far as traction control is concerned than your anti-lock braking system can adjust how quickly it is stopping and then releasing your wheel as it locks it up. So improving on that 2.05 seconds would be possible, assuming that you're using electric motors and you have a very clever traction control system. And also, again, it's all dependent on the tire technology. And we're assuming in this case that tires are the only thing accelerating the vehicle. Now, on the Tesla Roadster, the tires it's using are Michelin Cup 2s, and they are basically the grippiest tires you're going to find out there on the market for street-legal tires. Perhaps the Nitto drag radials are equally capable in a straight line, but these Cup 2s are basically just fantastic in the dry. They're going to have tons of grip. And one of the things to keep in mind is that companies work side-by-side when developing tires for cars. So Tesla may have, reached out to Michelin and said, hey, let's make, the grippiest Cup 2 you have for this car, for this specific scenario, and they kind of collaborate on it. The Nitto tires were a combination of, Dodge's working with Nitto to develop this tire that was specific to that car. So Tesla could be doing the very exact same thing to help improve the Cup 2s with Michelin, come out with a very specific compound, which for this specific car works perfectly and gives it the best acceleration possible, beating that 2.05 second claim. Now, there is also a tweet out there where Elon Musk hints at putting rockets on cars. And whether or not he's joking is besides the point. If you are to put a rocket on a car and you're not accelerating it with the tires, you're no longer limited by grip. You're just limited by how much thrust that rocket produces. So whether it's a compressed air tank or a physical rocket or whatever, you can hit a 0 to 60 time of 0.1 second, 0.001 second, whatever you want, if you put a powerful enough rocket on something that's capable of accelerating that quickly. All right, my final segment, smoke and mirrors, and there's a little shadiness going on with this product launch, and I kind of just want to talk about that. Some of the numbers that they say people get super excited about, but they're without context and ultimately they're meaningless. So that's what I wanted to talk about here. 10,000 newton meters of wheel torque. That's their claim of how much wheel torque this makes. Great, that tells us absolutely nothing. It's a huge number, and it probably will have a ton of torque, but this tells us absolutely nothing because we don't know how much power the car makes. So, 10,000 newton meters of wheel torque is possible in any car out there, assuming you change the gearing. So in first gear, you have more wheel torque than in second gear. So you can manipulate gearing to have whatever wheel torque you want. It doesn't mean the car is powerful. It doesn't mean the car is fast. So this number, until we know how much horsepower the car makes, ultimately doesn't matter, and you shouldn't really care about it too much. It's going to have a lot of torque. It's going to be quick. We know that. But this number is nothing to get super excited about until we actually have context. Their second claim, that this will be the fastest car in every, you know, way measurable. So 0 to 60, quarter mile, and top speed, I would assume, because that's actually what fast means, right? Like highest top speed. So they claim now 250 miles per hour plus. You know, perhaps they're targeting 300 miles per hour, and they don't want to say it yet because there's kind of a competitive world going on for that right now. But if they truly are going to make the fastest car out there, then it's going to have to beat Koenigsegg's current world record, which is like 277 or something along those lines. I would guess they're probably aiming for a very high number, and they don't want to talk about it now, hence they're just saying 250 miles per hour plus to not have this kind of battle going on about hitting the highest top speed. And then finally, it has a 200 kilowatt hour battery. And this part I believe, I'm sure they are going to stick that 200 kilowatt hour battery in it. But what they're not telling you is how heavy this 200 kilowatt hour battery is. The Tesla P100D weighs 5,000 pounds and it has a 100 kilowatt hour battery. The Tesla sells a Power Pack 2, which has a 210 kilowatt hour battery pack essentially. That battery pack weighs 3,600 pounds. So I would guess, and this is a worthless guess, so don't take it too seriously, but their battery pack is probably going to be weighing around 2,000 to 2,500, 2,800 pounds. Just the battery alone. So this car is going to be extremely heavy. So while it may accelerate very quickly in a straight line, it's going to have a problem managing heat because it's so heavy. So braking, accelerating, that's a ton of energy required to accelerate that much mass. It's a ton of energy required to decelerate, to brake that much mass. And so as a result, there's going to be a lot of heat rejection required from the cooling system. And Tesla currently is struggling to, you know, provide consistent lap times where the car doesn't overheat, go into this limp mode. And I think it's going to be the same case with this car because it's going to be so heavy, so much energy, so much power that it's not going to be able to reject all of that heat. Now, that's just me making that up. Maybe they'll be able to solve the heat rejection problem. It'd be super cool if they did. If you could actually track one of these cars rather than just go to drag strips and go in a straight line for, you know, 8.8 seconds and then stop. But either way, super cool car. It's exciting. And I hope they actually do meet these claims and hopefully in the year 2020. If you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching.